2020 has begun in traditional fashion, with the motorsport season kicking off with the Dakar Rally, but it's brand new in Saudi Arabia for 2020, and a brand new challenge for some of the leading contenders in the world of motorsport, including, just behind me there, Fernando Alonso. We're going behind the scenes with Toyota and the Dakar Rally. Join me. Right in the centre of scrutineering for the vehicles here, and an opportunity to show you all the different classes. So just over my shoulder is a kind of a brand new category over the last couple of years for Dakar. It's called the SSV category. The cars are limited to a set speed of around 130 kilometres an hour. They generally don't have a gearbox, so they've got a sort of central gearbox, just an accelerator and brake. And then you've got the real cars over my shoulder, the Borg-Vord team. Over that shoulder is a Mini, plenty of Minis, plenty, of course, of Toyotas as well. Then we have the quads category. It's kind of becoming a little bit less of a thing, the quads, because the SSVs are taking over. So there's only about 25 of those. And then, of course, the bike category. KTM, Husqvarna, Hero, Honda, loads of different works manufacturers fighting out. Probably about 15 really good riders competing to win Dakar, but it's always been dominated by KTM over the last couple of years. And then finally, the big old trucks. Kamaz, the men to beat, as per usual. So over something like 400 vehicles, 400 teams, 5,500 kilometers to try and cover across 2 weeks. They might have to cover 700 kilometers in a one day, with maybe up to 500 kilometers worth of competitive action in that day. What an adventure for these guys. What I really like about the Dakar is it is a bit of a family, and everyone looks after each other. And even today in the admin checks, you can still see it with all of these people here looking after each other, saying hello, having not seen each other for a whole year. It's nice to be back. Back at the hotel, I want a coffee. Woo! All the admin's done. Podium's now done, drivers have gone over the podium. It's still kicking off though with some amazing, spectacular acts. But our act is to go into the desert for day one of Dakar 2020. I reckon we've gone about 800 kilometers from Jeddah up the Red Sea, but now we've turned off from that and heading inland, and suddenly it's mountainous. Not kind of what I expected. Saudi Arabia, but looks pretty cool. We're going to try and find a spectator point that we've been given. It's just GPS coordinates, so we're going to find that, and then hopefully we'll intercept the cars. But it's kind of difficult. You never know quite where they're going to be. So we're about 300 kilometers into stage two of the Dakar, and we've come to what they've called a spectator point, but actually this is a checkpoint. Checkpoint five. There are five or six of these vehicles on every single stage, and all the competitors will come through here and get a time card stamped to show that they've come through this point. Kind of an old school way of doing things. Of course, GPS shows that they would have done this. There's also medical as well. Amazing logistics to have all of these cars going to different GPS points every single day, you know. And this one is close to a road, so it's relatively easy. But as we get more and more into the empty quarter of the desert, these guys will be literally going into a dirt area with no tracks, setting up their checkpoint, and then that becomes an important part of the Dakar route. Pretty cool, right? So the beeping you can hear when they get to this point is the warning system to say that there is a speed limit zone here. And the navigational system called Trippy, that's in the cars and on the bikes, gives an audible signal to say, right, you need to slow down. So you can hear it on the bikes really easily because obviously it's outside. Right at this point, with no other signals, is a 50 kilometer speed limit zone all the way through under the bridge until they get out into the open desert once more. First slight cock up from my part, to be fair, because I've been trying to work out with this rather ridiculous map drawn by a child where the finish and the start is.
because everything's so secret, it's even a secret for us as to how to get to places. And we've been trying to analyse the map, and we analysed it wrong this time, and therefore we're kind of lost. Toyota bivouac. Here are all the tents in which the mechanics would sleep throughout the rally. No hotels for them, all of these pop-up tents. And then for the management, the caravans, and also for the drivers. This will be where the cars will be in a few moments' time. So the scale of the operation there, the Toyota Gazoo Racing Team consists of four cars: Nasser Alatia, Ginny Elvillias, Bernard Tenbrinker, and Fernando Alonso. There are the four cars for the main team. And then, this is basically a South African team. They make the car, they build the car. And then the overdrive team over in the back are the customers. So they buy those cars and they operate the cars for clients. One, two, three, four, five, six clients for the overdrive team, meaning a total of 10 Toyota Hiluxes across the board. All the boys are getting ready, waiting for the cars to arrive, and when they do, they will all spring into action and get on with service for the evening. The Dakar is a 2 week long adventure over 5,000 kilometres of Saudi Arabia. So join us for more on episode 2 here on Let's Go Racing.